Good morning, children. In yesterday's class, we learned about muscle tissue, and all the other types of connective tissues also we learned, like areolar tissue, adipose tissue, bone, tendon, ligament, cartilage. All that we learned. Then epithelial tissues also we completed. Nervous tissue also we completed. Only one component of animal tissues, that too. Component of connective tissue is left over, that is blood. In that connective tissue, blood. So what are the names, children? Can you recall the different types of connective tissues which we covered so far? Areolar tissue, adipose tissue, bone, cartilage, tendon, ligament. So about all these types of connective tissues we learned, is it not? Structure and functions. So all these types of connective tissues, if we observe, including blood also, blood is also a type of connective tissue. Of all these types of connective tissues, blood is unique. Blood is separate from other types of connective tissues. So if you recall the structure of other connective tissues, you observed only one type of cells which are present in different types of connective tissues which you learned, is it not? So blood, it is not there like that. Okay, so here blood is different from other types of connective tissues. In what way? Means the blood is having different types of cells. Different cells are present. Okay, in the blood different cells are present. Apart from that, all the cells are doing different functions. Whereas if you take cartilage or if you take tendon or ligament, what do? They are doing one function like, okay. So for example, adipose tissue if you take, it helps in storing fat. Okay, areolar tissue if you take, it helps in giving framework, like that. Whereas here, the different blood cells which are there in the blood are doing different functions. So different functions are going to be carried out by the different blood cells. Apart from that, here the extracellular fluid is there. Extracellular fluid. Whereas the intracellular fluid means inside the cell we can take. So that fluid content whichever is present. Whereas all these cells, different cells are present in the extracellular fluid. In that fluid, these different cells are present. What do we call that extracellular fluid? Extracellular fluid. So that extracellular fluid, whichever is present in the blood, is called plasma. Is it clear to children? It is called as a plasma. So if we get any disease like fever, if that fever is not controlled, then if we go to doctor, what doctor will tell you? Go for blood test, like, is it not, children? Why the doctor is advising us to go for blood test? Because the blood will give the wellness or illness of a person. Okay, so if we observe that complete blood picture, it is going to give the information about health or the disease with which we are suffering. Is it clear to children? So here, in that way, it is different. So now, the extracellular fluid, whichever is present in the blood, is plasma, and we are not going to observe any fibers. Fibrous material we are not going to observe in the blood. Is it clear to children? So now here, basically, if we see the blood, So blood is, now you learned that extracellular fluid is called plasma and different types of cells. So now that makes the blood unique or different. Is it clear to children? So now if you observe keeping our hand like this, and if we see that small veins or arteries like which are present in superficial layers of skin, we can observe cutaneous skin. So if we can see that stream of blood. Is it clear to you? So where that blood is flowing? Blood is flowing in the blood vessels. Blood is flowing in the blood vessels. That also we can able to know. And where the inside the blood vessel it is just moving. Is it clear to children? So closed type of circulation we are observing in our body. The heart, when it is pumping blood to the different parts, the blood is flowing in the blood vessels. So closed type of blood circulatory system we are going to observe. Okay, so now here let us learn about the importance of blood and in what way it is unique and what are the different types of cells and functions carried out, that all we will discuss. So now blood contains two important components. One is a extracellular fluid called plasma and blood cells. Okay, so now usually the blood, here it is given, our heart pumps nearly 36,000 liters of blood, 36,000 liters of blood in a distance of nearly 20,000 kilometers in a period of 24 hours it is happening. Okay, so if you get hurt or injury, you can see the blood of ours will be red in color. How we got that red color? Red color to the blood is because of a pigment called, so some of the animals and human blood, if we see it is red in color, that is because of a pigment called hemoglobin. Okay, the red color to the blood is given because of hemoglobin. But some other animals like cows or lions or other animals, if you see, they also have red in color blood. Blood is red in them. But are we going to say that they are related to us? Is it correct? No. Is it clear to children? Whereas some other animals, if we see, cockroaches. So if we kill cockroach, you can observe white color. So the blood of cockroach is white. It is colorless. Why? Because this coloring pigment is not there. Whereas some other animals like snails, if we observe, okay, they have a blue color blood. Some mollusks also have a blue color blood. See, so blue color blood is because of hemocyanin, and here red color is because of hemoglobin, and white color means there is no pigment at all. Is it clear to you, children? But all the animals which have red color in blood because of the presence of hemoglobin, we are not going to tell that they are related to us. Is it clear to you, children? So it's really wonderful to study about the blood, which is said to be a connective tissue. So now a normal healthy person, a human being, will have 5 liters of blood. 5 liters of blood. Normal healthy persons will have 5 liters of blood. Is it clear to children? If that much blood is not there in our body, then sometimes it leads to health problems. Is it clear to you? Sometimes it may be present more, then there is no problem. But if it is lesser than 5 liters, then that results in the problems related to health. Is it clear to children? Then, now the blood contains chief component of the blood, which is said to be plasma. In that plasma, the main component is said to be water. So water is the chief component of the blood, children. Is it clear to you? Water is a chief component of blood. So here the liquid content or the matrix of the blood is called plasma, which contains water and other types of blood cells. So what are the different types of blood cells we have? So there are three types of blood cells. One is said to be RBC, then WBC, then platelets. Platelets. So like that, three types of blood cells we are going to observe. So where these three types of blood cells are there? They are freely flowing, or they are freely moving in a plasma, doing their own functions. So that is the reason the blood is unique among all other connective tissues. So it is said to be, blood is said to be fluid connective tissue. So you will be given a question, how can you say that blood is said to be a fluid connective tissue? So you know that the blood, it contains two important components. One is the matrix or the extracellular fluid, which we call it as plasma. The chief component of plasma is water, and in the plasma all the three types of blood cells are freely flowing and doing their own functions, and they are connecting each and every part, even cell of our body, from head to toes. Is it clear to children? Tips to toes. The blood is supplying different things to the cells. That's why the blood is unique among all other connective tissues, and blood is the only connective tissue which is in a fluid form. Is it clear to you? So that's why blood is called as fluid connective tissue. So now let us learn the components of blood. So we know that so plasma and cells. Plasma and cells. Okay. So now the chief component of plasma is said to be water. Then it contains, the plasma contains organic and inorganic components. Organic and inorganic materials are present in the plasma. And here, what are the organic components present? Means lactic acid, urea, salts, etc. are present. Then vitamins, hormones, glucose, proteins, all these will come under organic molecules. Carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals, all these are organic molecules which are present in plasma. Along with that, some excretory products are also present, that lactic acid, urea, salts, sodium chloride. So all these are present in a plasma, organic and inorganic components. Apart from that, some other gases are also present. Oxygen is there, carbon dioxide is there. So all these are going to be present in that. Along with that, there are factors which are responsible for clot formation. Clot formation. So what do you mean by clot formation? The blood has to clot after any injury or wound. So within few seconds or minutes, the wound has to be healed up, children. If it is not happening, then severe bleeding will be there, that results in the sometimes severe problems. So you know that severe bleeding, if it is there, then the people cannot survive if they met with accidents. But blood bleeding must be stopped. So that naturally bleeding is stopped because of some clotting factors. which are present in plasma, which we call them as a heparin. Heparin and porphyrin. Heparin and porphyrin are there. They are responsible for blood clotting, and heparin helps to prevent blood clotting. Okay, in the blood vessels. So, heparin is preventing blood clotting in the blood vessel. So, inside the blood vessel, if blood clots, will that blood supply to each and every cell of our body? No, children. So, these factors are helping in blood clotting, where the bleeding will be stopped. That is external. Whereas internally, the blood clots are not forming because of heparin. Is it clear to you, children? So, that point you have to remember. So, what are the components present in plasma? Plasma is the chief component, liquid content of the blood, and chief component of plasma or blood is said to be water. The plasma contains organic and inorganic substances. So, organic substances are glucose, amino acids, or fatty acids, etc. And inorganic molecules, urea, salts, sodium chloride, then other substances, lactic acid, etc. Okay, apart from that, the plasma contains clotting factors also. Clot formation is happening. Okay, so heparin is one chemical which is present in the plasma, which helps in preventing blood clotting inside the blood vessel. Is it clear to you? So, that is about the components of a plasma. Is it clear to children? Everybody understood? The chief component of a blood or the matrix of blood is called plasma, which is in fluid form. Major component of plasma is water. It contains organic and inorganic substances. Okay? Organic molecules means here you know that all the glucose, amino acids, they are needed for our body. So, each and every cell is going to be carried with that. They are present in the blood only. Is it clear to children? Then coming to the next point, cells or corpuscles. Cells or corpuscles. Is it clear to children? Cells or corpuscles. So, there are three types of cells. RBC, WBC and platelets. RBC, WBC and platelets. Okay. So, now all these different types of cells are freely flowing in a plasma. Is it clear to children? So, now let us learn about the different types of cells. RBC, first let us learn. There are red blood cells. Red blood cells. They are also called as erythrocytes. Erythro. It is red. Okay. Erythrocytes. RBC are also called as erythrocytes. Where do these erythrocytes are going to be produced? In the bone marrow. Bone marrow. Is it clear to you? The red color to the blood is given because of these erythrocytes, which contain a pigment hemoglobin. Hemoglobin. Is it clear to children? What is the function of this RBC? So, RBC are helping in respiration. Respiration. Why? Because of this hemoglobin. So, this hemoglobin is acting as a respiratory pigment. Respiratory pigment. Is it clear to you? So, this hemoglobin, whichever is present on RBC, is acting as a respiratory pigment which carries or which binds oxygen as well as carbon dioxide. Both are going to be carried. Okay, from the heart, when the blood is supplied to each and every cell of our body, oxygen is there, oxygen richer. When the blood is brought to the heart, then what is going to happen? The carbon dioxide, whichever is produced in the cells, it is going to be carried through the hemoglobin only. So that's why this respiratory pigment hemoglobin is a binding oxygen as well as carbon dioxide, and oxygen is supplied to the cells and carbon dioxide is taken back from the cells to the and carried to the heart. So that's why this RBC are taking part in respiration, like also we can learn. Is it clear to children? Then the production of RBC in bone marrow, we call it as erythropoiesis. Erythropoiesis. Is it clear to you? And the 1 ml of human blood contains 5 millions of RBC. So if we take 1 ml of blood for testing, so in that 5 millions of RBC are present. Okay. So why they are more in number? Because they have to carry this oxygen as well as carbon dioxide. So the RBC are produced in bone marrow, and the lifespan of RBC, how many days the RBC are going to survive? So lifespan of RBC how many days they live means only 120 days they survive. Is it clear to children? 120 days they live. After 120 days, what is going to happen? New RBC are going to be produced. Where are they produced? In the bone marrow. Where do we observe that bone marrow? Suppose if we cut the bone and see, so inside this we can see hollow space where the cells are going to be observed. So that one we call it as a bone marrow. So inside that the new RBC are going to be produced, which we call it as erythropoiesis. Is it clear to children? So that 1 ml of human blood contains 5 millions of RBC. 5 millions of RBC. Is it clear to children? So usually the RBC, they are round, circular in shape, and so here so RBC are generated in the bone marrow of long cells. Is it clear to you? But when we are in embryonic conditions, when you are developing in the mother's womb, the RBC are produced in liver or spleen. Liver and spleen are digestive glands. Okay. So all the mammals, they have RBC, they have nucleus in their RBC. But camel and llama, very important. Camel and llama, these are animals. Camel is a desert animal. In cold regions, cold countries, we observe llama. Okay. So this RBC are not having nucleus. Very important bits. All mammals, if we observe the RBC, mammals means which feed their young ones with milk. Cow, goat, horse, sheep, any herbivorous animal or carnivorous animal, omnivorous animals like human beings. If we see, the blood will be red color. Okay. The red color to the blood is because of hemoglobin. So all the mammals blood RBC, if we see, they are having nucleus, whereas camel blood, if we observe, or llama blood, if we observe in the RBC, they do not have a nucleus. It is very very important bit. Is it clear to children? Then that is about RBC. So here it is given, taking blood of an adult, we can make a chain of RBC. So it makes 7 circles around the earth's equator. Is it clear? That many number of RBC are there in our body. Is it clear to children? So RBC, they live for 120 days, and the carry respiratory pigment oxygen as well as carbon dioxide, children. Then they are produced in bone marrow in adult mammals. Whereas when the baby is developing inside the mother's womb, the RBC are produced, new RBC are produced in a spleen or liver. Is it clear to you? They live for 120 days. So where do this dead RBC will go? Again, dead RBC will go to spleen. Okay, spleen is the graveyard for a dead RBC. Is it clear to you? So they are going to be engulfed. Is it clear to you? Or they will be just sent out of the body. Dead cells. They are not supposed to be present in the body. So like that. So in embryonic conditions, remember, embryonic conditions means when the baby is developing in the mother's womb, the RBC are produced in spleen and liver. Okay. And in adults, okay, more than 15 years, 16 years, tarvata, 40 years, 50 years varuku, the new RBC are going to produce in the bone marrow, inside this bone marrow. Is it clear to you? So after the death of RBC, the RBC will reach the spleen where they are getting destroyed or degenerated. Okay. That's why spleen is called graveyard for RBC. So that lysosomes which you learned in the first lesson, they are going to be helping in destroying dead RBC or any other cells. So that is about this RBC of blood. Now we will come to the second type of blood cells, that is WBC. WBC, which is said to be white blood cells. White blood cells. So here this WBC, they are white in color because they do not have any pigment. So WBC, so they are also called as leukocytes. Leukocytes. Is it clear to children? So this WBC, again they contain the cytoplasm. In that cytoplasm, granules are present. What are granules? There are nothing but proteins only which are providing nourishment to the cell. Is it clear to children? Then these are less in number. WBC are less in number compared with RBC. That point you have to remember. And they do not have hemoglobin, so they are white in color or colorless, and so they are called as leukocytes. Is it clear to you? So depending upon the granules present in the cytoplasm, the WBC are of two types. One is said to be granulocytes. Granulocytes, and other one is said to be agranulocytes. Agranulocytes. Is it clear to you? So one is granulocytes and other one is agranulocytes. So granulocytes, if we see in the cytoplasm, we can see large number of granules. That's why the name granulocytes. So if it is absent only cytoplasm, if we see, they are called as agranulocytes. Is it clear to children? So this granulocytes are of just three types. Three types. They are said to be acidophils, then basophils and neutrophils. Neutrophils. So here agranulocytes are of two types, where they do not have granular substance in the cytoplasm. So they are called agranulocytes. One is said to be lymphocytes and next one is monocytes. Lymphocytes and monocytes. So like that, this agranulocytes are of two types and granulocytes are said to be three types. Acidophils, basophils and neutrophils. So the production of WBC is called as a leukopoiesis. Leukopoiesis. Production of RBC is called erythropoiesis. Production of leukocytes is called as a leukopoiesis. Is it clear to children? Then Coming to the next point here, WBC are going to help in protecting our body against the diseases. They help in maintaining immunity of our body, and they are responsible for controlling different kinds of bacterial or any other infections, like fungal infections, bacterial infections, or viral infections are controlled because of WBC. So that is the reason WBC are called as a body defenders or microscopic policemen or scavengers of our body. Is it clear to you? So about this different types of WBC and their functions, we will discuss tomorrow.